In the previous video, we talked about the basics of Procreate, how to get started using your brushes, your colors, your eraser, a little bit about layers and sharing your work, but in this video, we're going to go a little more in depth. When we open up our brush library, again, you'll see a ton of different options here, and as you start to play around with them, you'll notice that they behave in different ways. So, for example, in the calligraphy category, there is a brush that's called Brush Pen. I'm going to choose that one. And as I write with this, if I press down really hard, then my line looks like this. Okay, if I press down lighter, using less pressure on my Apple Pencil, then you can see that the stroke is a lot smaller. So I didn't adjust my size over here. I'm actually changing the size of the brush based on how hard I press down. So if I start with a light touch and then press down harder and harder, it's going to make the line thicker. You can also see it's a little bit more transparent when I'm not pressing as hard versus the complete opacity as I press down harder. So this different behavior of the brush is created through the brush settings. So as I open up my brush library and tap into the brush, you'll see all of these different options for you, and Procreate has put together some really effective brushes using all of those settings. So I recommend just leaving that alone for now. We do have some videos about how to create different brush styles, but for now, just use the default ones because they have some excellent options for you. If you do accidentally make a change to a brush, you can always reset it by dragging it to the left and choosing that reset option, and then it will allow you to go back to the default that Procreate gave you. So for the calligraphy one, we have changes in size and opacity based on how hard we press on it. For other brushes, it depends on the angle of your pencil. So for this one, as I am going up and down with my pencil, like it's pretty upright to my iPad, then that's what the stroke looks like. Now if I tilt my pencil more, you can see that the stroke is getting bigger. So for this one, the pressure doesn't change the stroke width. The tilt of your pencil does. So as you start to use these brushes, you will notice that they feel a little bit different in your hand as you write with them. Some of them look completely different from others, and that's the beauty of digital artwork, is that you can play around with all of these without having to waste paint or paper. You can just draw for hours and have fun. Now let's talk about some more advanced settings of the brushes. So if you have a brush, right now I'm going to use the sketching brush, the HB pencil, and you're writing with it, you increase it to the maximum size, 100%, and it's still not as big as you want it to be, you can change the brush settings to make the maximum size possible a little bit bigger. So just open your brush library and then tap on the brush you want to edit, and I first recommend duplicating the brush just so that you have a copy of the original. So you can duplicate a brush by sliding it to the left and choosing duplicate, and it will rename it HB Pencil 1. Then tap into the brush and you'll have this brush studio appear. Go to Properties, which is towards the bottom, and then this one called Brush Behavior has maximum size and minimum size. So if you wanted the maximum size of your brush to be even bigger, you can drag this up all the way to max, or just as big as you'll need it, and it shows you a preview on the right-hand side as you're going. So we can increase the maximum size, and now when we have our brush set to 100%, it writes a lot bigger. Let's clear all of this off, so I'm just going to open up my layer menu, tap on the layer, and choose clear, and it will get rid of all of that. Okay, so another thing that you can change about your brush is something called streamline. If you are creating, let's say, some hand lettering, and you're doing some flourishes, and they're not quite as smooth as you'd like them to be, maybe you're doing some circles like this, and they don't look super smooth, you can adjust the streamline. So let's open up that brush again, and then tap on HB Pencil 1. Up here we have something called stroke path. We have spacing, streamline, jitter, and falloff. We're looking at streamline here. So right now streamline is set to none, and as you write something, let's just do some random squiggles, it's going to give us the preview over here. As we increase streamline, you'll see it change a little bit. And what's happening when you do streamline is it's going to self-correct your curves. And as you draw with it, you'll notice that it almost looks like there's a little bit of a lag as you go. And that's because it's correcting it as you go. So if you have some curves and things that aren't as smooth as you'd like them to be, you can adjust the streamline setting and it will smooth those out. So that's kind of specific to hand lettering and calligraphy, but it may work for other pens and brushes as well. Let's go to our calligraphy set and find that brush pen again. Okay, we want to add a new layer here on top by opening your layer menu and tapping that plus, and then we can hide our squiggle layer. So now we're on layer 2. Right now, if you use the default brush pen in the calligraphy set, and you create some strokes. We have some thin lines and some thick lines, and that's what gives us a calligraphy look, the contrast between thick and thin. If you're having trouble getting your thin lines to stay thin, so for example, if your thin lines are a little bit too thick compared to what you'd like it to be, you can adjust your pressure curve. So let's go up to our settings up here and then go to preferences. Then there's one called edit pressure curve. Yours may look like this right now, just a straight line, and not to get too much into it, but basically this is showing you how hard you press versus how much the pressure of your brush is going to be affected. So for this particular brush, when we aren't pressing very hard, it's going to give us a thin line, and when we press harder, it gives us a thick line. So editing this pressure curve will allow us to make changes. So right now if I drag this bottom left corner all the way to the right over here, then I can draw thin lines almost no matter how hard I press, unless I press super hard. So basically, it's making it easier for me to make thin lines. I don't have to worry about having a super light touch, but it makes it really hard to make thick lines. So let's go back to this pressure curve and put that back where it was. If we drag the top one to the left, then it will make it really easy for me to create thick lines. And right now I'm barely touching on my pen and it's giving me a really hard time of creating thin strokes, so I have to be really light touched on here. You'll feel this when you do this on your own. So we want a happy medium here. I'm going to reset that. Now most people are heavy-handed, which means that it's harder for them to get a thin line because they're pressing too hard. So if you are in that boat, then what I recommend is adding a new dot on here just by tapping anywhere on the line and then dragging it to the right a little bit, and also drag this bottom left one to the right just a little bit. And that's just going to make it easier, so it'll end up looking like a curve. It's going to make it easier for you to get consistent thin lines without having to worry so much about having a light touch. You can press a little bit harder and it'll still have a thin line for you, and then the harder you press, the thicker it will get. So that pressure curve is going to be universal no matter which brush you choose. Let's use the water pen one, go to our preferences, and you can see that the pressure curve is the same. So same exact settings. You can adjust the pressure curve for individual brush settings, but that is going to be a little too complex for us right now. We'll just stick with the universal one. Another cool trick you can do with brushes is you can create color-changing brushes. We have a whole separate video about this, but this is going to change the color, hue, or saturation or brightness based on how hard you're pressing. So for this brush, if I press harder, it's yellow. If I don't press as hard, it's pink. This is all based on the math behind it, and we have a separate video teaching you how to do that if you're interested.